spotted. Bearing 0702, 200 marks.
Assumed to be a Brigga cruiser.
Comb 201 squadron, move to confirm.
Comb 201 Alpha, copy.
Permission granted.
Comb 201, sending Comb 202 and 203 for reinforcement.
Commander, unidentified vessel confirmed as a Brigga escape shuttle.
Why would a Brigga pursue another Brigga? Capture the shuttle. Top priority.
Comb 201 Alpha, Brigga escape shuttle priority.
Comb 201 Alpha, copy.
Kara 22 killed in action. Body can be renovated. Let's consolidate casualty data and begin transfer.
Around its blue parent planet, Gaia circles Anun, a world at war. Once, this world was controlled by 8 tribes called the Garm. Brigga, Worm, Basse, Seta, Borzoi, Zenin, Kumtok, and Columba. Each tribe had its own form and language based on its function, and they served the god who created them. However, Danann the Creator left this world one day, and these tribes who were left behind began to fight each other for supremacy. After a long period of conflict, the atmosphere has been contaminated and the surface left covered in ruins. Of the eight tribes, only three, the Brigga, Columba, and Kumtak, now remained. And even the druids said to convey the word of God have died out. The Brigga have established dominance of the surface with their military might. The Columba rule the skies by deploying mechanized units. The Kumtak have barely managed to survive by offering their superior information technology to Brigga. The Brigga and Columba, the two great tribes of land and air, were about to begin battle of dominance over Anun.
Consolidation complete. Thank you for your brave service to the Kiakra, Kara 22. New identification code for the squadron is Kara 23.
ID code unknown. Accessing auxiliary brain. Infiltrating memory hive. Function, system analysis and interrogation. Also information management.
Consistent with the Kumtak information officer serving the Brigga.
Scan the Garm terminal access log.
Last access, minus 3716 set.
His breach was minus 2517 set. You're telling me he's been off the Garm network for over 1,000 sets?
He must be operating as a standalone.
What about that other individual?
Type, unknown. Function, unknown.
There's a powerful firewall in the subject's auxiliary brain.
Could be a trap. Auxiliary brain manipulation is a Kumtak specialty.
Try the Kumtak's memory nest again. See what he knows about the other subject.
Scanning. Extracted.
Type, Druid. ID code, unknown.
For the sake of argument, let's say it is a druid. The more important question is not one of existence, but of action. What would drive a Kumtok to flee the Briga?
If the terminal access logs are correct, he's been on the run for some time. We've no choice but to interrogate them directly if we're to learn anything of substance.
Wait. Trace data detected in the Type Druid's headgear and secondary buffer. Extracted.
Are you the Columba pilot that died trying to save us?
What if I am?
Thank you.
I was just following orders.
Maybe so. But it seems like someone else would like to thank you. You seem entitled to receive a blessing. Although that would be for a Gula to decide. Garm in this ship restrict a Gula's movement? To be touched by a Gula is to receive a blessing of great fortune and protection. To the best of my knowledge, Nacien is the only one the Gula's ever blessed. Would you care to try?
Where is the Gula?
A Gula is always searching for someone or something.
Thank you.
down here.
Interrogation will commence. Kuntak, who is that individual you fled the Briga with?
My dear interrogator, you are aware of the existence of the Sage of the Trees? Those who convey are the words of our creator, Dana.
If by the Sage of the Trees you mean Druids, then yes, we are familiar with both their existence and extinction.
Yes, along with the Worm, the Basse, the Seta, the Brazoi, and the Zenon. All extinct after years and years of war. Now with the Kuntak near extinction, only the Columba and the Briga remain in any significant numbers.
Your point, Kuntak? Every Garm knows this. These are keystone memories of our collective database.
Yes, but just because you commit something to memory, does not make it a fact. In our collective memory, the last of the Druids were killed off long ago. But the truth is, one survives. Druids are said to have access to tremendous power, and if that power could be harnessed, then total systems dominance could be achieved. That, at least, was the thinking of the Briga.
The Briga tried to use the power of the Druids.
That sounds like something they would think of. There are stories that a Kuntak once tried to use Druids to gain the power of Danann and challenge the Briga. That Kuntak's ambitions brought great shame to his pack. And he was ousted from the clan as a heretic. Surely there's no need to follow in the footsteps of that Kuntak, who played with systems beyond his comprehension and ended up a pariah.
No matter how much the Columba boast of their speed and mobility, the Briga's mighty warships and armored forces remain as great a threat as ever. Would you not call attacking a powerful enemy the very height of foolishness?
So why have you come to us? The Briga and the Kuntak have been united for countless cycles.
Enslaved, not united.
So you've come to offer us the power of the Druids against the Briga in exchange for your tribe's freedom?
That is what you want, then yes, that is what I'm offering.
Gula.
Kuntak, you say that by combining our power with that of the Druid, we can destroy the Briga. How do we know that what you say is true?
If you allow me access to the ship's information core, I will combine it with the Druids. And you will see firsthand the true power of the Druid.
Don't be ridiculous, Kuntak. You'll trigger an overflow and destroy the brain case. Sir. You aren't seriously considering giving him access, are you? The Kuntak are notorious for their skills in manipulating data. How do we know what this Kuntak says is true? That it's not all some elaborate trap by the Briga, sir?
Give the Kuntak access to the Kiakra's main core.
Sir!
There is a Druid standing before you. A Druid. Don't you understand what this means? Give the Kuntak access now.
Yes, sir. Port opened in the staging area firewall.
Thy right hand, So teach them to fear thee. See for yourself the power of the Druids. Anan, you make yourselves known to us only in visions. We only speak to you in dreams.
Stop it! Cut her off! Cut her off!
Behold the power of the Druids!
Listen up. Our primary objective is to take back the Kumtak and the Druid. Alive. Ignore the Gula. Any Columba you kill on sight. Team 1, take care of the sleep hive. Team 2, hit the hangar and ground as many six wings as you can. Now the rest of you, follow me.
Into the ship's information core, detected from the Kiakra.
Air traffic control section isolated from system. Connected directly to information core.
Fire control section isolated to
port security systems offline.
Navigation and control systems integrated with information core.
Set the CIC to autistic mode now.
Share combat information center. The system merges all of the main building.
Call 301 to Kiakra CIC. Come in. Air patrol to Kiakra CIC. Multiple Brigger warships approaching. Kiakra CIC.
Air to ship combat alert. Prepare to launch aircraft.
Wondering how I was gonna get this thing open. Don't even try, Kumtak. We're taking you and your little doll back to Brigger Command.
Ah!
Contact the Rosmerta. Objective secure. Now let's move.
Thank you. Kuntak! Is this some kind of joke?
The Torque Sea, where the corrupted land of the Garm ends and the sacred land of the Druids begin.
You said this was the way back to Brigga Command.
I have no intention of returning to the Brigga.
Get this ghoul out of the way.
Even an obstinate brigger like him knows it's a grave sin to kill one who's been blessed by a ghoul. Mana. It makes you faster, stronger. Allows you to heal more rapidly than if you were in your sleep hive. But there's a price to pay. If you use too much at once, your body will destroy itself from within, accelerating your metabolism, aging you, wearing you out.
You talk like you know more about the Garm than they know about themselves. Like you've forgotten you're one of us.
Have you ever wondered what it truly means to be a Garm? Our core memories are so limited. Think. Your weapons. The Columba carriers. The Brigga cruisers. The systems that operate them all. Nothing was created by the Garm. How long have they existed? No matter how hard we trace our memories, or how we trace the records, the answer is the same. Nothing is created by the Garm. They've existed from the very beginning. The Garm don't create. We maintain. If we don't know where we came from, how would we know where we're going?
Heresy. What you're saying is heresy. A Garm fulfills his mission, that's all.
Is it? Do you know where you are? You know what that is? The Torque Sea. Don and our creator made it to separate the Garm from the lands of the Druids.
Those lands are forbidden to Garm like us.
Only there can I follow the memories of Danann, who vanished from these lands.
Danann.
Don't you? Don't you want to know why our creator left us?
Thank you.
Once across the Torque Sea, Nassim will lead me to Dual Grund, where I can gain access to the upper-level systems of the Druids. That is where the truth behind Donnan's absence lies.
And what about me? And the Brigga? You just expect us to follow you?
Cut off from your packs, gone like you will die, wandering in the wasteland. Your memories will not be downloaded, you will not reawaken in your sleep hive cells. But in Dual Grund, you may find another fate waiting for you. What, I cannot say. But cut off from your pack as you are, the choice is yours. The tide is rising. Are you coming or not?
Where do you think you're going, Kumtak?
Across the Torque Sea. To Dual Grund.
You're not going anywhere. My mission's to take you back to Brigga Command.
You can die now, or later on your own out in the wasteland. But we're going to Dual Grund.
You're not gonna make it across on foot. Get on.
Why should I trust you, Brigga?
Because if I could kill a Garm blessed by a Ghoulah, you'd already be dead. I've come too far to let this crazy Kumtak just walk away. You wanna go to Dual Grund? I'll take you. Once your business there is finished, I'm gonna take this crazy Kumtak and the Druid back to Brigga Command. And the Ghoulah could do as the Ghoulah pleases.
Deal.
So you do have some sense, Columba.
It's Kara. Kara 23.
You're telling me your generation code? That information's only shared within a pack.
I am Wid. Wid 256. The Druid is Nassian. 666.
You're kidding me. I'm Skellig. Skellig 58.
These people who have all lost their packs miraculously meet and begin their pilgrim's journey to the Holy Land in search of the memories of the Garm.
Thank you. Not bad. Funny. A ghoula could live where birds are. But we can't.
How much mana do we have left?
Three summers. If we're strict with rationing. And it'd be even less if the druid didn't seem to be surviving off her connection with these stones. Even if we make it to Dual Grund, if there's no mana there, we're finished.
You're regretting your decision?
A brigand never regrets his actions. You remember that.
Came to relieve you.
I'm fine. Go back to sleep.
I can't sleep when Wood sleeps so soundly. What does he know that we don't?
I thought you trusted him.
Hardly. I can't shake the feeling that he had something to do with the disaster that brought down the Kiakra.
Well, if you can't trust him, what makes you think you could trust a brigand like me?
We have a deal.
Unbelievable. If you're Code 23, that means you have a long service record as a warrior. A Garm without a pack tends to throw caution to the wind.
If that's true, I'm not the only one.
It's not the same thing. I have my mission. You made a choice.
Out here, is there really a difference?
Go get some rest. If I need relief, I'll come and wake you.
I told you I'm not tired.
What did it feel like to be touched by Ghoula? Do you feel any different?
It's just... I don't know how to explain it.
She drools a lot. Was it sticky?
I felt something warm and soft when she touched me. Not on the outside, but on the inside, if that makes any sense. and her scent. I feel like I've smelled it somewhere before. I don't know. Your Briga pack didn't have any Golas?
We used to. I never saw one. No. Gulas are short-lived. And clones are forbidden.
Skellig, what's your first memory?
Target practice, maybe? Mission briefing?
No. Back further. What's the first thing that you can recall ever experiencing? For me, I think the first thing that I ever saw was light coming in when my sleep hive cell opened up. Your first memory isn't something similar to that?
So what if it is? We're gone. We fight, we die, we download. Being around the druids going to your head, Columba. What is your first memory? Why is it any more important than your third or your tenth or your last?
Skelly, why are there no young Garm? Gulas give birth to pups. Even birds of the Torque Sea, like, raise chicks from eggs? Why is it just the Garm that have no young?
Denon created us that way.
Why would Denon create the Garm to be like that? What was the point?
Is that why you want to go to Dual Grunt? What, to find answers?
I don't know. You asked if something changed when Gula touched me. Something did. I don't know what, but something inside of me changed. And if going to Dual Grunt tells me what that something is, then so be it.
You should go. Can't see anything, just this fog.
It's too dangerous to keep going. We're stopping.
Wait. I think the fog's thinning out. Skelly, there on the left.
Distance, 390 Nortes. What is that? A hill?
Can travel from this world to the other using their wings.
The place where the world ends and the world begins.
Dual Grunt.
This is the place. The exact vision that Nassim projected in my sleep.
In your sleep? You mean you dream?
I thought only the Gula were blessed with the ability to dream. Until I met Nassim.
doubt it. I've regretted my decisions, and yet... coming to the Holy Land... it could bring disaster to the Brigham.
There's no turning back now, not for us. Nor for the world. If we are the harbinger of things to come, what lies ahead? If that was not the case, then why would a heretic like me and Nassim have turned up? And you can't say that Kara willingly left her pack.
Neither did I, suppose.
Perhaps we'll have a more different future if Donon's curse is lifted.
The future. That's such an absurd concept.
Brigga, all we have is the future.
Welcome back. Guess there's no turning back now.
Cold feet, Skellig?
Only way forward's on foot. Someone's gotta be back up, and I'm the only one that knows how to work this thing. You keep your comm channel open. You run into trouble, just say the word. Kara? What?
The first time. It's the first time you call me by name. What about you?
I don't need as much mana as you. Besides, I got my pal here if anything goes wrong. You said there was something you wanted to find out, a dual grunt. Go find out. Go find out if there's a future waiting for us, for Garm. Something that's different than this. Go.
80 marks ahead. Do you see it?
I see it. I'm picking up two more on your left and right as well. Look out. They're moving.
I'm going in for a closer look.
Be careful, Kara. Whatever's out there, it's big.
Distracted. I'll find the cables.
Kara, can you hear me?
Wid, go ahead.
We found an access point. Nassian's gonna try to disable the defense system, but it will take time. Can you keep the remaining giants distracted?
Just hurry, Wid.
I'll take the big one. You take the little one.
Big one? Little one?
Thank you.
disengaged the system. We're safe now. Kara, do you read me?
We've located the position of the central terminal, the core of Dual Grund. Now, Cien will show you the path.
We have to help Skellig.
Forget Skellig. Nothing could have survived that explosion. Kara, if you want to know the truth, forget Skellig. And follow the path that Nacien reveals.
Begun to flow once more. The time of the God.
Garm's extinction has begun. Your body will still prove useful to me. The brain case of a Kumtok will be able to freely access the Central Garm network. I shall make free use of it.
However,
all non-essential memories will be deleted from it.
I am Wid. Wid 256. I am Wid. Wid.
Give it up. There's no way out. You're trapped in there. My name is Kara 23. Now tell me, why do we fight? What meaning does the Garm's endless fighting have? Answer me.
The owner of this body already appears to know the answer.
Then tell me.
What was is and ever shall be. I form the light and create darkness. When this world was not yet formed, they came from far, far away. Then they divided this world into heaven and earth and filled the space between with living things. Finally, they created the Garm and bequeathed unto them a portion of their technology that allowed the Garm to control this world. The Garm were separated into tribes according to their abilities. Eventually, they named themselves Brigga, Columba, Kumtok. And they named the individuals that formed the tribe, and went on to name every living thing that filled this world. To name something is to show dominance over it. And when they were named by the Garm, they abandoned the Garm and left this world. They forbade the Garm the power to create new life, for they feared the Garm and their reckless desire to conquer all that was in their world. And since that time, the Garm have had no future, only a present. And now the giants will rise and burn anew to ash. What was is, and ever shall be. I form the light and create darkness.
Wait. What do you mean, ever shall be? Who are they, and where have they gone?
They've already begun their next experiment in the place closest to this world. That's why this world must be destroyed.
You keep saying they. Why don't you say their name?
Even now, you ask their name. They call themselves. It means jealous, for they are a jealous god.
Heavy warfare between Garm and